mentioned to me about how we had to be inside the sea water. He destroyed my soul. He went past the righteousness for his faithfulness. He gave to our walk in the valley of the shadow of death. Shield no evil for thy mercy. And all that stand. In the presence of my feet, I know I'm my head for my cousin, I'm going to give a good of all the needs of my life. I look away, I'll never go. Thank you. giving. Thankful, Lord and Savior of Christ. Lord, you have been other members of the clergy. The bereaved family and sympathizers and friends. Brothers and sisters, we are here this afternoon. Pay our last and final tribute to the homegrown of this island, our sister, Ellery Jones. We want to say to you, the family, that our prayers are with you. We pray that God will strengthen you with his might and satisfy you with his tender mercy, that you may find peace in his presence and comfort in his love. For our strong God, who is a present help in trouble. As the summer's psalmist tells us in the 121st Psalm, said, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord which made heaven and earth. At this time we are going to walk on this the rain rise to come and him see our program this time.
I need some glasses, but I'm going to see you.
gate, there are walking the family of Santa Fe, a few of me, now I'm looking, and the door, the step, the company, and the carriage, the table before me, the children and the kids, and I'm knowing the gate door, stuff I'm looking, sure,
all we want to do is Amen. Their family has just what they want. First of all, I want to honor the God and give the God this season.
Amen.
I know it's hard to see. I just didn't have it.
So she walked me through making the biscuits. Biscuits turned out great. So I called back to tell the biscuits turned out good. It's 11 o'clock at night. I think you tell me we're there for about 6 or 7. I told the Evan, what the hell is
when I would come home, sometimes I'd stay. anything that belonged to them. Even though she had grown me at that time, I still had to take something home of them. So I'm going to miss that. She was a good, she was an excellent worker, I should say. She worked at that nursing home, was not all she did. It was like, in her neighborhood, she took care of the elderly. She would go and say, I'd be saying to her, Ellie, what you doing? She's like, well, I got to go see my old friend. She's 100 plus years old, and I got to make sure she did. So she was just loving. In her own way, she was an excellent person. She was one of God's creations. And for the 76 years that we had her, my last phone call from her lasted over 3 phone calls. She called me and I was at work at the daycare and I said, okay, daycare, I had a talk on. So she said, okay, and she kept talking to her. She called me back less than 5 minutes and we talked. I said, Ella, I got to go. I hung up again. Ella called back. She insisted on talking to me that day. So I just said, good luck, I just called. And all she talked about was the call. I'm going to miss her. I'll miss the phone calls. I miss when I come here to see her. We all do, as siblings, I speak on behalf of our siblings. We're going to miss Ella. She didn't care which one of us she called. She was going to stay with me. Then she was going to stay with Charlie. I don't know if Charlie knew it yet, but she was glad to have it to stay. I said, okay, I'll talk to Charlie. Surely you're going to go stay with one of us. But God saw fit to prepare her home up there in that mansion that you have for all of us. So she's occupying her mansion. There's a mansion with a room that's so big that all of us can get in. All of us have a room in that mansion. Provided that you confess Jesus Christ.
All right.
I looked at him like, okay, what's up?
Yeah. Keep your life right.
Thank you. Vivian Henderson with a solo.
Thank you. Yeah. We pray now that you will bless this family. Let them know everything is going to be over. Now I want that the words of my mouth.
Oh, yes.
Meditation of my heart. Let it prove to be a self-will in us. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. The same to God say, amen.
He said, in this life,
about 3 years ago, 3 or 4 years ago, and she came to me after service. And she said, "Pastor, y'all hear me good now." She said, "I want to come back, but I don't want to come back to no mess."
Big shot. So your work's burned up, you
If you born once, you are not twice. If you born twice, you are not born twice. That's why the Hebrew writer said, it is appointed unto man once to die. So if you are born twice, you only die once. But if you born once, you're going to die twice. First of all, you need to understand the three different deaths. There's spiritual death. That's what happened to Adam sin. He died instantly, spiritually. Then you have physical death. When the soul and spirit leaves the body. And then you have what you call eternal death. That is permanent separation from God. So you need to understand, you're going to live forever. You are never going to live forever. Because you can't kill a soul. You can't kill a spirit. So you're going to go somewhere. And you're going to think it's hot out there now.
Oh, our condolences to the family of Lucia Elliott Jones, Reverend Alfredo Carswell, from the pastor, officer, and members of Fellowship Baptist Church of St. Austin, New York, to extend their heartfelt sympathy to you on the loss of your loved one, Lucia Elliott Jones. We pray that God will comfort and strengthen you for this time of bereavement. We offer our deep sympathy to the Elliott Jones sister, Deacon Josephine Morrell, who is a dedicated and very active member of Fellowship Baptist Church. Psalms 29:11 encourages each of us that the Lord will give strength unto his people. The Lord will bless his people with peace. Please be encouraged and may strength upon that there is healing and comfort for the love of Jesus in your heart. Rest assured that a loving God will be your everlasting life and your days of sorrow will be easy. We pray traveling mercy to all who have come along this homecoming journey. The sun has set on Sister Jones and new morning has come for her to be in the presence of the Lord. If we can't be of any assistance, please do not hesitate to let us know. Lord of Christ, Reverend Alfredo Archibald, and the Fellowship of the Apostle Church.
Thank you. motherfucker.